uniting communities throughout the six. This is Urban Definition with your hosts Sassan, Kareem, and Zayn on CHHA 1610.
What up, what up, what up? Today is Wednesday, August 31st, 2016, and this is yet another week of Urban Definition. As per usual, I am joined in studio by my co-hosts, Mr. Sassan Mirzai.
Hey, guys.
And Mr. Zayn Jinnah.
Hey, everybody.
What an awesome week it has been. And by awesome, I mean stressful. The amount of things that is currently going on in my life is overwhelming. But what about you guys?
The complete opposite, actually. I haven't had too much to worry about, luckily. You know, knock on wood, that could change very easily. Sassan, how about you?
Well, I'm pretty happy. I went to my favorite concert this weekend, and the band retweeted my Instagram, so...
It's funny, I wasn't going to say anything, and I was going to wait for you to be like, this amazing thing happened.
Because I was so excited. I was like, they've noticed me. This is happening.
Sassan, that is awesome. You know how many times I've been trying to get musicians or whatever concert to retweet me or something? I am so happy for you. You have no idea. You're living my dream here.
So at least tell us a little bit about the band that you went to go see and how this developed into something epic and awesome.
Well, it's like a mix of three different bands. It's Starbomb and one that I won't say on the radio and Tupperware Remix Party.
Okay.
And Tupperware Remix Party is like this instrumental 80 devil-like band in Toronto.
And this is the type of music that you you gravitate towards.
I don't know. It's because these guys mixed with a bunch of YouTubers, and they made this like gaming band. So they sing songs like the Poke Rap, except like a new version, but it's all comedy.
Okay.
And they have a Zelda rap and whatnot.
Interesting.
Yeah, they're really fun.
Okay, but you still haven't gotten into...
Starbomb.
You still haven't gotten into how this became an epically awesome thing.
Huh?
You just introduced who they were, but you never told me what happened.
What do you mean?
Okay, so you went to the concert.
Oh, yeah. I was just taking pictures that night. What do you mean? And I did my daily Insta, and okay. He saw it, took it, and basically, I was, like, playing Left 4 Dead on the weekend, and while I was, like, helping my friends, I got a notification. It's like, the band has commented on your photo. I'm like, wait, what? They've commented? So I looked at it, and it's like, wait, they didn't comment. They actually took the photo and used it, and I was just, like, panicking.
And they gave you credit, right?
Yeah, they gave me credit.
Yeah, I saw that. It was like, at Sassé, and I was like, check this guy out. And I'm like, did he shoot it on a DSLR? Did he shoot it on,
it was
a red?
Sadly on a phone.
And this guy, and I look, and Sassé says, no, it's on my, the Nexus 6?
The 6P.
6P.
It's the same phone that takes our pictures of Instagram after the show.
It's true. Our social media pictures are also the same, is taken on the same device that's used to take pictures of Sassan's epic, weird, but epic, musical choices band.
It was actually really funny, because I was looking through the other pictures, I was like, why did he pick my picture? And it's because the other pictures didn't use HDR.
Ah.
That's the only reason mine got picked.
Interesting.
So there's a correlation between HDR and a band picking your picture.
Apparently so, yeah.
It was the lighting, because in every other photo, all the band members were like pure white because of the lights. HDR fixed it. Thank you, Nexus.
All right, I'm going to ask this just because like it'll be like my last question for this. Were the people white people at least?
Yeah.
No, because you said they all looked white. So I was like, they looked white, are they white?
One's Middle Eastern.
Ooh.
So, yes.
Yeah.
Pretty much. In some cases, anyway.
Now's the time when I'm not really the time. This is usually, unfortunately, we got detoured because of Sassan's epically awesome retweeted picture or reposted picture. But this is usually at the beginning of the show, at the top, I usually ask, what's going on in the world?
Oh, well, for one, this is the last day of August. So tomorrow starts September, and that means the fall is coming real quick. Not really something that's happening in the world, just a kind of a footnote to have out there that like, hey, just so you're aware, summer's pretty much over.
I like the fall. Fall's my favorite season.
It's a good season.
It is a good season. I enjoy this season. But that's not what's going on in the world. That's what's going economically. Not even economic. That's like, what's that?
I don't know, calendar wise.
No. I'm talking about what's it's the study of not biology.
Not chemistry.
I don't think this really matters.
I know it doesn't really matter. The word will come to me and I will announce it hopefully by the end of the show, but it's if you know, please let us know. Zayn, how do people tell me? How do people educate me on what this study is?
A great question, Kareem. Everyone can go to our website at www.urbandefinition.ca. And they can click on the Facebook and Twitter tabs, in which you can then post, use the hashtag Urban Definition, tweet at us, post on our Facebook wall, let us know what your thoughts are. As for what's been happening this week in the world, let's get to it. Peel high schools are now using, or they're going to get gender-neutral washrooms, which is a huge step forward.
It is a huge step forward.
Peel region.
So Peel region.
Oh, is that Saga?
Yeah, that would be considered Saga.
Oh, okay.
So I guess the whole thing with them is that they're going to be introducing... Well, it's not going to happen right away. They're going to start integrating it in little by little. Gender-neutral washrooms. And my assumption is that this was probably... during the CNE this year, that was something that the CNE had introduced, was gender-neutral washrooms that use a picture of half male, half female. You know, the whole tagline, we don't care what you are. Everybody needs to go at some point. Anyways, I feel like that was like the determining factor where Peel Region was like, all right, cool, other people are doing it. Now is the time for us to do it. Which, it's high school, though. We're not talking like university or like fully developed human beings. We're talking high school. When people are like still going through puberty, high school, where a lot of madness tends to ensue. We're talking about high school. Thank you, Allen Iverson.
We're talking about practice. but here's the good thing about that, though, that even though it's in high school, it's more inclusive and it gives students a place of kind of a sense of safety as well. Because think about all the stories you hear of kids getting bullied in locker rooms and change rooms and things like that, or where they go into spaces where they're teased and bullied and things like that. At least with the gender neutral bathroom, it says it doesn't matter who you are, what you look like, etc. This is a bathroom for you. And it's good because at that age especially are when a lot of opinions are formed, a lot of your knowledge is set, a lot of when you're looking at the world very differently. And with that comes the education of, you know, it doesn't matter who you are, what you look like, a bathroom is a bathroom for all. So that's my personal take, at least, on having gender-neutral washrooms and why it's such a good thing.
I wonder if it's going to be like South Park where the children will need a key to get in, because otherwise... At a high school, I feel like all the couples are just going to use this to make out.
And I feel like you and I, well, not you and I, all three of us have discussed this on a previous episode, on a previous show a few weeks ago. And it's, for me, it's like this whole thing about, like, there's no consistent balance to hypersensitivity versus realist, like, the actual society that we live in. So it's this whole thing about people, you know, getting up in arms this day and age being like, how dare you assume my gender? And it's like now basically what we're doing is we're buying into this system, which in some ways can be considered ridiculous. And that's only because of the people who take advantage of it, like your couples over there. Yeah. But at the same time, I mean, I understand there is a need for this type of situation. I get that. But at the same time, does this also exemplify how we're buying into what I would like to call the millennial trend?
Are we really feeling the fire, though? Because it's at that age that a lot of things about yourself you don't know that you discover. I mean, think of how many people come out now from that age. Right, there was that before, that was the issue, and then it was okay.
Okay, but the thing is, coming out as, you know, if I'm a male and I come out as gay, mm-hmm. does that necessarily warrant me having to go to a gender-neutral washroom? I mean, that means that I'm a man who is attracted to males.
Yeah, you still use the men's washroom.
I still use the men's washroom.
Let me back that up. It's not that in specifically, it's the principle behind it that... It is giving a safe space and a place to learn that and to understand it. So, like, back in the day, if you were gay and you came out of high school, you were going to get bullied. Like,
I feel like gay
times.
Is the wrong principle or the wrong example to use in this situation. I feel for this, we have to really focus on trans.
Okay, fine.
Not necessarily, you know, I love males. It's I'm a male who identifies as a female. That's the kind of direction that we need to go with this type of conversation.
And you know what? Maybe it's something that's been happening for years that has been under the radar, but now is coming to light. And that's what I meant by that whole other example was it was there, it exists, it was not acknowledged, and now it is acknowledged, and now there's things being done to accommodate that. In this case with trans, it's there were situations where students felt they were assigned one gender but they identify with another, and now it's becoming more prevalent, and now there's steps being taken to accommodate that.
I honestly feel like this is something as simple as they're gonna be limiting teacher washrooms and just posting gender neutral signs on teacher washrooms now.
That's terrible.
It's probably true. I mean, realistically, come on now. The amount of money they'd have to invest to build new washrooms, the plumbing, come on. Plumbers are the most expensive people to hire in the world. So what do? They're going to put gender-neutral signs on teacher washrooms.
Oh, my God.
Poor teachers.
You don't disagree with me? Do you disagree? Hey, man, that's what I think.
I can see that happening, really. They take advantage of it. Why not?
So do teachers have to run all the way to the staff room when they want to use the washroom?
No, I'm sure. My thing is that I think, like, each floor... You know, like, in high school... I don't know about your high school, but my high school, every floor had at least 2 or 3 teacher washrooms.
Oh, we didn't have that many.
I think what'll probably happen now is that, like, let's say there's 2 or 3... Now one of those on each floor will be designated to the gender-neutral washroom.
Oh, I guess that could work.
Yeah. Sassan's like, oh my gosh. Kareem, you're terrible. I mean, I don't know, man. It's one of those things where there's no clear definitive answer or clear definitive, you know, line as to do we go this way, do we go that way. I honestly think that in some ways, it's a step in the right direction. In some ways, it's a step in the wrong direction. High school, I don't feel, is the right place to be implementing this. At the same time, who am I to say when is the right or wrong time? I feel like the best time for me personally, I would probably say, is more university. College, university age. Because for me, that's a little bit more to when people have a more mature state to be able to use that type of system responsibly.
Well, that would be an obvious time then as well, right? I mean, you would assume that in university, that's when these things are prevalent too.
That's true. But with that being said, we do like to hear what your take is, and we do encourage people to give us their perspective, because let's be honest, no two people think exactly the same. So Zayn, how do people chime in on the convo?
Visit our website, urbandefinition.ca, click on the Facebook and Twitter pages or tabs, and post and comment. Let us know what your thoughts are. Do you think this is appropriate? Do you think it should have waited? You know, what do you think is going to happen? How is this going to play out? I mean, there's a lot to speculate on, so we'll really have to visit this again. Anyways, everyone, keep it locked on Urban Definition. We'll be back after this commercial break.
Urban Definition. On CHHA 1610.
Welcome back. Before we went away to the commercial, we were talking about implementing gender-neutral schools in the Peel region, and we were saying that we would love people to chime in, which we still do. We got the post up on our Facebook page, also throughout, for example, my Kareem Ali's Facebook page, and leave a comment. With that being said, it is time to move on to our next segment, which I like to call Real Talk. Now, for those of you who have never tuned into the show before, Real Talk is typically a segment used to speak about our personal thoughts and reflections and take on a number of different topics. Today's topic, however, is a little bit different. For those of you who grew up in the 90s, even into the 80s, the term nerd was never considered a positive characteristic trait. You know, especially when it comes to in school and stuff like that, if somebody was called a nerd, it was more so a bit of a put down. Fast forward to the millennial age, which now we're into 2016, and even into the 2000s, the term nerd has become somewhat positive. So the first question that I want to ask, and we'll delve into this a little bit deeper, is what is a nerd? Sassan? I don't mean to go to you first, Sassan, but I had to on this one, and I'll explain why after.
Okay, when I was growing up, we had three words: dork, nerd, and geek. and I had, like, different categories for each, and nerd was, like, Dungeons and Dragons and just, like, lots of reading, like, C++ books and, like, programming. That would be nerd.
Okay.
And then geek would be anyone who's, like, who likes computers, games, that kind of stuff. And then dork is just, like, anyone who likes popular culture, like Pokemon and Dragon Ball, anime, that kind of stuff, that kind of nerd. What do you guys think?
Zayn?
I guess they kind of crossed over a lot of the time. So I like how you categorize that, though. It makes a lot more sense now. It gives a little bit of definition. It's still wrong, but I'm glad you did that. I agree with that. In my time, it kind of crossed over. I mean, one was never different from the other.
Okay. For me, nerd defined somebody who was into things outside of the hegemonic norm within the school system. So what would be considered inside would be things like music, sports is a huge one, and those are probably the two biggest things, is sports and music. You know, sports can be obviously all sports, cheerleading, stuff like that. Music is obviously, you know, whether it be hip-hop, top 40, anything outside of that. When people identify with, you know, K-pop, for example, for, you know, that type of stuff, was like, oh, what a nerd, what a loser. Whereas, and it's different because, well, for me, I grew up in a predominantly ethnic, predominantly ethnic school and also a predominantly Caucasian school. So things outside of, you know, those two little brackets there, which are actually huge brackets, but still, would be considered outside and completely different. Somebody who was, you know, into the books, you know, focused most of their energy on school, their marks, stuff like that, that's a nerd. Anybody who is into, you know, comics, cartoons, anime is a nerd, stuff like that. And because of that, they were always considered, you know, an outsider. And, you know, people who lacked athletic ability, that's a nerd. Somebody who had their mom as their best friend, that's a nerd. Somebody who didn't, you know, tend to those sleepovers and, you know, hang out with other kids outside of school, that's a nerd. So yeah, that was, growing up for me, that was a nerd. Second question to you guys is now, millennial day and age, what is a nerd today considered? What describes a nerd or the characteristics of a nerd this day and age?
Sass, you want to take this one first?
Well, for me, nerds nowadays, they're the hipsters. They're the ones who, like, try and be different when they're not actually different. They're the ones on Tumblr. They're the ones just looking for reasons to get out of the norm.
Okay.
That's my new definition of the nerd.
So you're thinking more hipster. So your thing is like hipsters.
Yeah.
Okay.
Were they ever in the norm to begin with, though?
Yeah, that's...
Because everything he defined was everything out of the norm.
Yeah. I think what Sassan's saying is, the norm has obviously changed at this point.
Yeah.
Which is a huge thing that we definitely do need to acknowledge. But I think for Sassan, it's the whole concept of, what's the most hipster thing that a hipster can say? I'm not hipster. And Sassy used to give me a hard time about it. I don't remember. Do you remember giving me a hard time about that? I'm not hipster. Kareem, you know, you know how you know it's a hipster? How? When you say you're not hipster. I'm like, oh my God, I hate you. That's anyways. But I understand where Sassy's coming from. Do I think that defines a nerd? Probably not. I feel like this day and age, kids just want to be nerds. Like, they're just like, being a nerd is such a cool thing. Comic books, totally cool. Anime, totally cool. Sports, buh. And it's just like, what? I mean, I know a lot of guys now that were like huge jocks growing up. And now they're just like, yeah, man, I'm all about that Batman life and that Gotham City. And I'm just like, what are you talking about? The closest you ever came to like following anime was watching Scooby-Doo on TV growing up.
So then the definition hasn't really changed from the 90s. It's just become looked at better.
No, I feel it has changed. And in that, it's that what Sassan touched on is the fact that, you know, people want to be different. And what different is what we used to... You're both a bit right. Like, the whole thing is different now is what different was in the 90s that everybody now associates with, if that makes sense to you.
That's not how I see it, and that's not how it happened, really.
No, I took a bit of both of what you guys said.
I know. But for me, nerds, like, I grew up in Richmond Hill.
Yes, so, Rich Man's Hill.
Yeah, yeah. So remember that name.
Rich Man's Hill.
Okay.
That's the first time I've ever heard Sassan say, remember that name.
So everyone in that area, we had Game Boys, we had N64s, we had Dreamcast, PlayStations, computers. We had all that stuff. So we were the ones who were just, we were all nerds. And then the first day I walked into university, that's when everything changed. Because my university was in Toronto. I was with you guys. It was at Ryerson.
Yep.
That's when I realized not everyone's like that. Toronto's completely different.
And you know what's funny is in the first year of university, I literally thought Sassan was the weirdest person on the planet. And it's not because of Sassan. It was because of the company that he kept. And the fact that the people that he hung out with were probably considered the quote-unquote outsiders of what the hegemonic norm of our program was.
But that's how I was in high school and elementary school. It's whoever wanted to be friends, we'd all, be friends. And that's how it was. Especially okay. French immersion. Elementary school, all French immersions, once you went to high school, you stuck together. And you merged with the other French immersions.
And Sassan did a great job at transitioning to the next, the follow-up of the transition of this conversation is, if you will. And that is, with all of these people living as nerds this day and age, because, well, really quickly, do you guys think everybody wants to be a nerd?
In some sense, yeah, they really do.
Everybody wants to be a nerd.
Yeah, no, but like,
be perceived as intelligent, right?
Anyways.
That's the main trait.
Yeah, the whole thing with that is navigating in a nerdy world at this point. And with Fan Expo this weekend, just around the corner, one of the biggest in-demand events or panels is, and Sass is gonna be like, you would find a way to integrate this into conversation. Beauty and the Geek speed dating at Fan Expo.
Wait, what? I thought you were gonna say Stan Lee.
No. Stan Lee is an iconic person that everybody wants to go see. I'm talking about navigating the nerdy world that we currently live in, and everybody wanting to, connect in some way, shape, or form. And how do these nerdy people find each other? Apparently, at Fan Expo, the most popular way for these people to find each other is through Beauty and the Geek speed dating, which Sassan and I were supposed to do, but that plan fell through. All on Sassan, not me.
Okay, you know why? It's because girls get in free and guys have to pay like $30.
Holy.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, let's be honest. That is primary. I have to take it back. That's primarily the reason why we were going to do it. But anyways, my question to that is, at these conventions, you have I wouldn't call it a fair mix, but it is definitely a mix of true nerds versus wannabe nerds. Thus, my question, are conventions the right place for nerds to find quote-unquote love?
That is a very different topic altogether.
I know, it's a completely different topic, and we'll get back.
I see where you're going with it. I would say it's not a bad idea, actually, because you can connect with like-minded people. I mean, it's the same reason you do anything, right? Why do people go to a nightclub to connect with like-minded people? Maybe to dance, too, but a lot of the times people are looking for something apart from just what is being offered, right? There's other people to offer companionship as well.
Well, the whole thing in this is that a true nerd versus a hipster nerd are very different things. Usually at these conventions, you come across a lot of people that do not necessarily fit the mold of what a real nerd is. And an event like Beauty and the Geek speed dating, which I feel is probably meant for people who are legitimately, quote-unquote, nerds, who really have a social anxiety when it comes to meeting people. This type of event was meant for those type of people. But now you have all these hipster nerds who are more than likely going to outshine the real nerds. And does that defeat the purpose? And are these conventions really where people should be meeting?
No, because nerds don't want to be hit on. This is this is so normal. All my friends, we're all geeks and nerds and dorks, and we find each other if we did want to date another dork in a video game or at gatherings, not at Fan Expo. Fan Expo is just to have fun, dress up, and be silly.
For those of you attending Beauty and the Geek speed dating, hit us up on social media and let us know. We'll be back. Actually, wait, we do want to hear from you, though. We'll be back after the break, though, guys. Stay tuned.
This is
Urban Definition. Urban, urban definition. On CHHA 1610.
Welcome back, everyone. For those of you tuning in right now, we just talked about being a nerd and if it's cool and all this other stuff. And, you know, for those of you who heard the conversation and you want to chime in, hit us up on our social media, Facebook and Twitter. Go to our website, urbandefinition.ca, and be part of the conversation. And now it's time for our...
Okay, hold on. No. Before we get to my favorite part of the show, I need to mention this because I said I would mention it at some point throughout the show. I had to bring it back. And for those of you who... I'm not going to go back into what I'm talking about. For those of you who tuned in at the beginning, you'll understand why I'm about to do this. Okay. The study of weather... okay, so basically, there's a number of different ways we could have gone about this. It's meteorology, climatology, atmospheric physics, and atmospheric chemistry. Those are the... One of those is what I could have said, and I didn't say, so now I'm saying it. Thank you. Now...
I'm glad... You know what? I'm so happy you were able to do that.
I know.
Just because it brought it full circle a little bit.
It's true.
There's closure on that. I won't lie. It makes me feel better.
I'm glad. Now, for my favorite part of the show. Here we go. Tech talk.
Oh God, please stop. That was way too long.
You know, he was longer last week, if you remember. Like, he started to run out of breath last week.
He did that weird like up down thing, and like
I've been working on my vocals there. I've been trying to see how long I can hold a tune, well, what I consider holding a tune at least, without starting to peak or hit puberty, apparently. I did pretty good.
I have to admit, you lasted a lot.
I'm proud of myself.
You lasted a good length.
And I'm older than both of you, so I'm proud of myself.
I don't have a singing voice, so I could never match you anyway.
Oh, okay. I guess we'll start tech talk. I thought you guys were going to keep talking.
For those of you who don't know, well, you guys can't see, but basically what just happened there is Zayn and I just stared at Sassan while he was looking down at his phone because that's where he writes his bullet points for tech talk, which we're doing again right now.
Anytime today.
This is what happens when you deal with people like Sassan.
What do you mean? Okay. I didn't know if you guys were like done your little rant, but okay, I'll just start.
He's still drawing out time. Look at this guy.
I'm not even looking at anything anymore.
His eyes were closed and he's just laughing.
Okay. So, you guys know about wearables.
I thought you said werewolves.
No, not werewolves. Wearables. Like
okay,
smartwatches.
Yes, wearables.
Okay. So, basically, Samsung has been thinking that women are not in the market anymore for their smartwatches.
I feel like they're the biggest market.
That's what I thought as well. So they had like this new analytics.
Sure. That? Okay. Analytics.
And they were like looking at the numbers and basically
you could have said study, but you decided to go with a bigger word.
Fine, study. So women usually buy things that have been out for a really long time. So let's say Fitbits and like sports watches and those kinds of things. So Samsung's new smartwatch, they basically said, hey, since they're not buying it, let's make the case really big, because that's what Samsung does with the Note. They were the first ones to make the phablet. And they made their new watch 46 millimeters. And I thought, that's not that bad. That's not really that big. Why is everyone talking about this? Because, wait, how big do watches go? Like 55 millimeters, like normal watches? Like,
you'd think the watch collector would know the answer to this question, but I don't.
Because I've seen watches go to, like, 55 millimeters. So I thought, 46 millimeters, that's not that big.
Yeah.
So then I was looking around, and Fossil, a really big watchmaker...
Da-da-da! Fossil!
They're making smartwatches now, too. And not just, like, those really dumb ones where it's just, like, a really tiny rectangle on the watch. They're actually making full-on smartwatches. And their biggest one goes to 47 millimeters. So I said, why is everyone, like, yelling at Samsung for targeting men when... This is happening everywhere. Why is Samsung on, like, the bad side of this?
Oh, you're asking us.
Yeah.
Oh. <'Cause>... I thought you had a solution here, because no. I was going to say the same thing you are. Doesn't make any sense to me. I don't know. I don't even know how big my watch is now. Like, it's just bigger than... I've seen guys with really big watches. I just don't understand the flash of it.
The flow of this conversation is really weird.
I want Kareem to, like, actually...
I'm looking down at something right now, and... I'm listening to what I'm hearing, but I'm not hearing what he's saying.
No, but Kareem, we need you to be in this conversation.
No, I am in this conversation. I will chime in, but I'm just, before I give my two cents, I do need to mention that what I'm hearing right now has nothing to do with watches.
What?
What I'm hearing right now is an onslaught of double entendres.
Oh my god.
All out of Zayn. Because all I heard was, I've seen guys with watches. I've seen guys with big watches. I've seen guys with even bigger watches. And I'm just like, oh god, please stop. Please stop this. Anyways, my two cents is that I feel like it's, I hate to do this, but I'm going to say it and people are going to be like, Kareem, why you got to do that for? But it's this. I feel like the market demand is opposite for both genders. I feel like this day and age, I see women with like more, and this is not my word, this is something that I've heard women say, clunky. They're into the clunky fashion, having, you know, the big rings that spread across four fingers, and having the big clunky Michael Kors watch.
Wait, four fingers? That's brass knuckles.
I know. But yeah. There's, like, I seen a girl with one ring that's, it was a spider, and it's spread across her whole hand.
That's crazy.
And that, apparently, is, like, the clunky fashion is, like, really in right now amongst females. And I'm just like, all right, cool. I mean, I'm not saying dudes don't buy it, too, but predominantly in terms of the quote-unquote trend, that's what I see a lot of, is that, you know, women are gravitating towards the clunkier pieces, and dudes are going towards the sleeker pieces. Now, in saying that, I mean, I'm biased because I do collect watches. I have a very vast watch collection. In response to what you're talking about, I feel like there's actually a, and I hate to break it down like this, and I'm so sorry to everybody in advance, a class difference. When you look at the high roller companies, I'm not even talking Rolex. Rolex to me is not the high roller company. Yeah. I'm talking about, like, the guys above them. They're actually gravitating towards making a lot of their pieces sleeker, thinner, and, you know, almost aligned with your skin, which happens to be a lot of what I'm buying these days. Even with Fossil, you look at what they actually, the expensive watches that Fossil sells, and I'm not even talking about going up to Skagen, which is their luxury brand. I'm talking about just Fossil right now. Fossil, their expensive watches are thin, really nice, classic timepieces. Whereas what you're talking about, which are, you know, the smartwatches and stuff like that, are really marketed towards a different clientele of people.
I don't know. They're going for the rich market. I know Best Buy is releasing like a $1,500 watch, and it's like gold. Wow. Has gold in it too, so I was like, smartwatches are going pretty
far.
Yeah,
but that's a little bit different, right? That's not for your sleek, that's not your sleek market. That's like your, I mean, your, what's the word I'm looking for here? The people who like to say, look what I have here on my wrist. I got gold on my wrist. You know, I'm going to wear my nice clothes with my nice watch, and I'm going to be fancy because I can do that.
Well, I brought this up because I thought, why is Samsung doing this? They should have done what Google was doing with their smartwatches, with the Moto.
I feel like Google is not a good company to represent success, because while Google has had, you know, a number of really good products, I'm still a fan of the Google Glass, I'm sorry. But with that being said, their model does not exemplify success. Their model...
Google? Are you crazy?
No, we're talking about, like, the tech stuff.
Yeah.
What have they done that's really exemplified a huge margin of success?
Chromebooks, Nexus.
The Chromebooks
Motorola.
Are not. I do not think that Chromebooks are a huge market for success.
They were huge back then. They were
back
the
then
first,
when?
Like, no, they were the first like.
At no
laptop
point
that was tiny.
Yeah, but people didn't. They were not. It was a great idea and a great product.
Yeah, and people are still making them.
But they're not huge. If you look at like...
Every university student buys it if they don't want to put programs on it, like Photoshop.
Do they buy a Chromebook, Sassan, or do they buy a netbook?
That's a Chromebook, though.
It's... No,
it runs
Chrome. From my understanding...
Chrome OS.
From my understanding, a Chromebook was a completely separate product, and there was legitimately a Chromebook that was sold. What you're talking about is an operating system, not a product, right?
Yeah, but they also made the product.
I understand that, but the product itself, the actual physical Chromebook, did not do well. Chromecast, great product. Selling-wise, I don't think did well. Google Glass, great product, didn't do that well.
Android.
That's a program, not a product.
Fine, but I thought Nexus did fine.
And what we're talking about right now is products, not programs. I'm not trying to knock Google. I love Google. I use Google every day. But product, they don't necessarily have, in my view, a great track record or model
then
for success.
Who's your favorite tech manufacturer?
Tech manufacturer. Huh. It's funny because what I think and what I do are completely different. I mean, you look at most of the products that I own, you would think that Apple would be my answer.
I thought it was Samsung.
But no, I mean, you look at what I own, like my MacBooks.
Oh, that's what
my you're... I have an Apple TV. I have had pretty much every Apple iPhone that's come out up until the 6, which I'm not going anywhere near. But I mean, really and truly, you look at my track record, it screams Apple, but realistically, it is probably closer to Samsung. Yeah, I think Samsung's probably the safer. Now, like looking at it now, I'd probably go Samsung, but looking back, I mean, I really bought into a whack ton of Apple.
Okay, let's move away from this. We stayed way too long on this one topic about watches. But I don't know, I thought they should make one for each gender if they really wanted to keep that sleek look.
But given today's society, people are going to get mad. How dare you assume my gender and produce a product that is supposed to be for my gender.
Exactly.
Yeah, probably not the best way to go about things.
We could still make like different sizes, like a little smaller, because even the smallest one's 44 mil.
That's actually what, I'll use Rolex. Rolex does, for example, and a lot of the brands do, is they'll make the same watch different sizes for males and females.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's move on. So I remember I was talking really bad about the Surface Pro 4 and the Surface Book in a past episode.
Yeah, you were ripping them. You were pretty savage.
Yeah, because Microsoft was doing so poorly with those products.
Yeah, man, you were totally like, I remember you just went ham and you're just like, I was like, at a certain point I was like, all right, Sassan, what are you doing? But all right, cool, you do you.
So I was like reading the news and apparently the Surface got a new update to fix all those issues. And I was like, now, really? They fixed the battery issues and all the Wi-Fi and all that stuff. Now? It came out in November. It's been almost a year.
Wow, so would you like really to issue them an apology now?
No, I'm not going to give them an apology. It's been over a year. The next one's coming out next November.
I think if anything, Sassan's expecting an apology.
I'm expecting free services for everyone. Like, those poor people who had to suffer with that for like...
Oh my god! Sassan wants free service! That's what you gotta get. Free service for Sassan!
I thought it was so stupid, but thank you, Microsoft, for finally fixing the issues, but please stop putting people in an alpha phase for your products. Like, what are you doing?
It's true.
Just finish your product, then release it. Anyway.
I totally threw Sassan off with that three-horn salute.
You did.
I love my three-horn salutes.
Okay, but like...
Big up to the three-horn salute, please! Let me go! I think I pressed the wrong button there. That was 100% my fault there. Let's do this again. Big up to the three horn salute! Yeah.
Oh gosh, okay.
This is why you can't have Kareem anywhere, or take Kareem anywhere.
I don't even know what else to talk about now.
I don't even know what we're talking about anymore. Microsoft is late on something.
I guess I'll like rush on stuff. Apple is releasing their little... What's it called? Their little thing where they talk about their new products? I forgot.
Sassan's done. Sassan's completed. Sassan's done. When we come back from the commercial break, Sassan will probably be able to talk about those points again. But as of right now, Sassan is completely toasted, fried, and wasted. In a good sense, though. But yeah. Sorry, guys. We'll be back after the break. Hopefully with no more three-horn salutes. But we will be back.
Joy, I see.
Definition. On CHHA 1610.
What up, everybody? Welcome back. Now, for those of you who are wondering what on earth just happened, let me explain to you. Listen, all right? We are celebrating something very special today. Well, not today. It's actually going to be Saturday. But either way, it is very special, and that is Mr. Sassan Mirzai's birthday.
Oh, God.
Sassan is turning the age-old 25, quarter century old. And for his birthday, I had a very special person who hopefully you guys will be able to figure out who it is, but a very special person who wanted to wish Mr. Sassan a happy birthday. So we're going to try this, and hopefully I play it correctly, but he wanted to speak a little bit too soon, but hopefully he speaks as he was supposed to this time. Please, take it away, my good man.
Joy I see, happiness, laughter, and cake. Cake, enjoy that, do I? Now then, happy birthday, you will have. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
There you have it. And didn't you like that high tone right there, too? There is no yeah. Try. Don't you like that high tone? Come on, be quiet. It's my turn to speak. But don't you like that high tone right at the end there? Where it's like, you. Who does that remind you of? I wonder. But for those of you who weren't able to identify who that was, that mystery birthday wisher was, and because it's Fan Expo this weekend, it was the one and only Yoda.
Oh my God, Zayn was right. I thought it was Cookie Monster.
And it ain't no... No, it was Yoda. It was Yoda.
Wait, hold on a sec. You didn't recognize Yoda's voice and I did?
Because Yoda would be the one who's like talking backwards. His vocabulary was pretty on point.
What are you talking about? He went totally backwards. Look,
he
Yoda,
said,
Yoda.
Happy birthday, have you will or something.
Yoda, come back and repeat what you just said, please.
Joy I see, happiness, laughter, and cake. Cake, enjoy that, do I?
See?
Okay, fine.
But oh, yeah. Man.
Oh, my gosh.
So, from all of us here at Urban Definition, we would like to wish you a happy early birthday.
Happy birthday, Sass.
Thanks, guys.
You should have seen him when you were playing that. He was, at first, he was confused, but you could see how much joy he had in his face. Just to hear, you got a special shout out, man. That's great.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Sassan is like sheer giggles right now. Like mad giggles. Sassan's like Gigglesworth.
Because you said quarter century. I feel ancient now.
Yeah, man, you're halfway to 50. At this point, you should just look into retirement plans and save up.
Oh, it's my God. True.
It's true. Now, with that being said, we do need to move on because you're not that special. Zayn, what's going on this weekend?
All right, well, this weekend coming up is a long weekend. It's Labor Day weekend, and that means everyone, well, most people have Monday off. So with that said, here's what's going down this weekend. On Friday, we have the CNE. Of course, it's the last weekend for that. Don't fight if you're going. There was a fight the other day that caused it to shut down early. Please don't hurt other people or yourselves. Let everyone enjoy the CNE. We also have Busker Fest at Woodbine Park, and it actually switched from downtown to Woodbine Park now. So this is the first time that's happened. It's the largest street performers festival in Ontario, and it has a bunch of musicians, sketch artists, artisans, entertainers, and it's going to be happening all over like the entire weekend. The festival features, and I'm just reading this part, over 100 performers from around the world in support of Epilepsy Toronto, which is a great cause. So if you're going to go, be sure to look out for that and enjoy yourself too. We also have the kickoff to La Burger Week on Friday, which is participating restaurants.
No, Zayn, you got to say it right.
Le Burger.
Le Burger.
Le Burger Week.
Straight out of the Pink Panther. I would like to order a hamburger. La hamburger. Sorry, Zayn, continue, please.
No, it's all good. Restaurants such as the Burger Priest, Thompson's Diner, and East 36 are participating, and they're going to give you discounts on their best burgers. It's a real good chance to go and check out these restaurants.
Hold on, what did you just say? All the expensive burgers, all the expensive burger joints are going to be giving us discounts?
All their best burgers, yeah.
I had to do it, I'm sorry, guys.
Now, I've actually never had the Burger Priest or any of these places, so this is something I'm definitely going to try to check out. And I encourage all of you guys to do it. Don't give me that look. I know. How am I living in this city and not trying it yet?
I think I've tried every burger joint in Toronto, like in terms of like the big ones that everybody's like, yo, you got to try that. You got to hit that place up. I think I've hit them all up at this point.
I'm a tourist in my own city. I still have so many things to learn.
Actually, fun story, really quickly. I once went burger hopping with Nunu.
Really?
Yeah.
I could see that happening.
It was really random, actually.
Yo, guy, let's just go burger hopping.
We did. All and right. Apparently it was, like, during this, like, really weird... I didn't know it was this time, and he was like, yeah, there's, like, this burger thing going on, and we literally walked on the streets at, like, midnight, 2 o'clock in the morning, just going to burger joints.
Oh, that's pretty cool, actually.
It was a very bonding moment.
Sounds like it.
That just got really intense really quickly.
We also have the Downsview Park Rib Fest. Sorry, let me repeat that. The Downsview Park Rib Fest at Downsview Park, of course. It's going on Friday to Monday. I think that's pretty self-explanatory. On Saturday, of course, it's Mr. Sassan Mirzai's birthday.
Yeah.
Yo, this guy went straight to the script, too, eh? That's how you know Zayn reads.
Yo, I got him, man. I don't have that much time left. there's also the Club Monaco's Farmers Market, which is the first time I've heard about it, but it's been running since June, so...
Yeah, I gotta hit that up before it closes.
I have not been up to date on my events in the city.
Do you shop at Club Monaco?
No, it's expensive, man.
No, it's not that bad, man. And for you, you shop at Zara, don't you?
Yeah, but like, I look for the par. Sales.
It's on par.
Really?
Yeah.
I gotta go to the clearance rack, man.
Sure. I mean, towards the front is where all the... Yeah, it's kind of like Banana Republic as well, where it's like, all the expensive stuff's in the front, and then really good prices.
And we also have Fan Expo, which is happening this weekend, as we've mentioned before.
Way to take that away from me, Zayn.
Oh, I'm sorry. And I was actually going to kick it to you guys to say more.
Fine. I will. But first, I'm going to ask Sassan to speak first.
Okay. For those of you who don't know, Fan Expo starts tomorrow, and it'll go from Thursday all the way to Sunday. Kareem will be there Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
I will be there all weekend, and I would love to see, hear, and chill with all of you, and I promise I won't be coughing when we chill. But yes, I will be there tomorrow for the official launch at 4 p.m. I'll be there all day, well, not all day, Friday. I'll be here for a couple hours on Friday to chill, hang out, check out some of the booths, shoot a couple videos out there with you guys, social media posts, give, you know, our local artists and our local vendors some representation and put you guys out there. Anyways, Saturday, I'll be hitting up some of the panels, and I will also be having the fortune of doing some sick interviews. I'm going to use the term, God willing, I get to meet Stan Lee and interview Stan Lee for all of 5 seconds, but let's be honest, that realistically probably won't happen. Saturday, I will meet up with Sassan, who will be in full costume, and I'm not telling you guys what he's going to be yet, even though I do know the answer to this question, but I'm not going to tell you guys. So instead, if you guys want to guess, go ahead. And if anybody can guess correctly, I will have a prize for you guys waiting for you guys next week, Wednesday. And that's only if you guys can get it right. To answer this question and to give a legit guess, you can do it two ways. You can either Instagram us a photo, or you guys can tweet us either the words, a post, or a picture of what you think Sassan might be. And if you guys can get it correct, like I said, there will be a prize involved. On Sunday, Sassan's going to be out of cosplay, out of costume, hanging out. We'll be outside the convention interviewing some of the people who choose to cosplay the Crasp out of this weekend, but not necessarily go inside. Have a little bit more in-depth as to why they do that and the approach that they take in their, I wouldn't say lifestyle, but their choices of being outside and the culture embodying outside versus inside. So yeah, all in all, this will be a super intense, fan, fun, super packed weekend. I anticipate rubbing shoulders, and I don't mean in a good way, with people left, right, and center, because let's be honest, Fan Expo is easily one of the most packed conventions I've ever been to, and unfortunately is less air-conditioned than AN was last year.
Oh boy, that sounds tight.
And if Cyanide and Happiness is doing their banana bar crawl, we're probably going to hit that up too.
Absolutely will. And I think every year I've gone with Sassan, we've managed to go to Cyanide and Happiness, because Sassan is one of those people that loves to get personalized drawings from the crew. And, I mean, let's be honest, who wouldn't? Cyanide and Happiness is...
Yeah, but I love them. I read their comics daily.
Yeah, they are pretty awesome. I'm more into the YouTube stuff.
Cyanide and Happiness on YouTube, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they're shorts.
Mm-hmm. That's where I gravitate towards.
Just a quick thing to mention to everyone. Monday is a holiday, so things are going to be running a little bit slow or closed. The TTC is going to be running on a holiday service schedule. Same with the GO Trends. It's going to be running on a Sunday schedule. Most malls are open except for Yorkdale, Fairview, and Sherway Gardens. And all your major attractions are open, so definitely enjoy your long weekend and enjoy your Monday, too. Why not?
All right. So, everybody, have a fun, awesome, safe weekend. Don't drink and drive because ain't nobody got time for that. Be safe. One love. Peace, guys.
Bye.
Take care.
CHHA.
This is Urban Definition.